Yes, Dylan.
Oh, you are? Well, send them in. Rachel?
Hello.
Oh, Mitch. It's good to see you. Appreciate it on such a short notice. Congratulations.
Not at all. Thank you. Now that Blaine's trial is over, things have calmed down somewhat. Look, can I have Nellie bring in some coffee?
No, thank you.
Well, then, please, have a seat. Now, what was it you wanted to see me about?
Well, I told Mitch that, that you thought that the company was still involved in the connection.
Well, I want you to know, Mitch, that I received my information from a very reliable source.
Yes, I know your source was correct.
You're certain of that?
Yes.
Well, then I can't understand why you went to work there, Mitch, knowing the company's connection. Now, surely you must have realized it would jeopardize Rachel's chances of getting custody of Amanda.
Well, that's the point. I didn't know until yesterday.
Jamie, is that you?
Were you expecting somebody else?
No. Are you just getting home?
Does it make a difference?
Yes, it makes a difference.
Why?
Because I'm your wife and I care about you.
Do you?
Come here. What's the matter?
You didn't answer my question.
What question?
Do you care about me?
You know I do.
And do you trust me?
Oh, what are you getting at here?
I'm leaving today.
Leaving? Where are you going?
Just north of town. The Herald Clinic.
What's that?
A psychiatric clinic. I'm going there for psychiatric observation. And I was just a little curious how you'd react to that.
Well, if you're leaving tomorrow, I don't want to keep you. You probably want to leave early in the morning.
Yeah.
Jamie.
What?
I really appreciate you coming here.
Well, I think we should do this again sometime when I get back.
Yeah. Maybe then I'll be in a little better mood.
Ah, I think you're rude. Real nice. Bye.
Bye. Jamie, thank you so much. It meant a lot to me.
Yeah, well, I'll see you soon.
Yeah.
Take care of yourself.
I will. I...
Well, Brian called the house this morning. He wanted me to get a hold of you.
Really? Why?
He wants to see you.
About what?
He didn't say. He just wants to see you in his office.
And now, the continuing story of Another World.
How do you want me to react?
I don't know. I guess I wondered what you thought of the idea.
I'm not sure. I mean, this checking yourself in, does that mean that you're committing yourself?
Yes.
For how long, Jim?
I don't know, a week, 2 weeks, as long as it takes.
Does Mac know about this?
Yes, I told him last night.
And what does he think?
He's given me his full support.
And Rachel?
I haven't told her yet.
But you are going to tell her?
Yeah, today, before I leave.
Well, I think this is a good idea. I really do. I think you're doing the right thing. It's going to work out very well in the long run.
You think so?
I know so. I wouldn't say it if I didn't. So, you're going to leave today?
Yeah, sometime this evening.
Do you want me to drive you?
No, that's all right.
Jamie, are you sure that you want to do this?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to miss you. But I think you're doing the right thing.
Then what you're saying is that when you went to work at the Connection, you knew nothing about the company's involvement.
That's right.
But didn't you even suspect that they were involved? Especially in light of the fact that Jordan Scott had been involved with this Connection.
Yes, it had occurred to me, yes.
Didn't you ask before you agreed to work there, Mitch?
Yes, I did. And I was told by Jason that the operation was clean.
Look, I'm afraid I'm having a little trouble understanding you, Mitch. I thought you and Jason were friends.
Well, yes, we are friends.
Well, then why would he deliberately lie about the company's involvement?
I think he thought he was doing me a favor.
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
Well, I needed the money. But he knew that I wouldn't take a job unless I knew that the company was not involved in the Connection.
No, but didn't he realize that sooner or later...
Yes, he realized. As I'm saying, as far as he was concerned, I think that he thought he was doing a friend a favor.
Well, I can't tell you how much Jason's generosity has complicated this case.
Well, won't it make a difference, Brian, the fact that Mitch didn't know that the company was involved?
Yeah, if we can prove it.
Well, if it's any help, I'm not working at the Connection. I quit as soon as I found out.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Mitch. That may be a point in our favor.
Do you think it'll sway the judge?
I don't know, Rachel. But we're going to do everything we can. That much I promise you.
Yes, it's wonderful. Didn't know you knew how to cook.
I don't. Haven't you noticed we haven't eaten anything but sandwiches since we moved here? It doesn't come out of a can or out of a frozen food package. Just forget it.
We didn't do so bad with these eggs.
Yeah, well, it's pretty hard to ruin scrambled eggs.
That's true. You know, I think one of us ought to learn how to cook. I mean, we can't live on eggs and sandwiches for the rest of our lives.
Why not?
Funny.
No, I'm kidding. You're right. One of us will have to learn how to cook.
Why are you looking at me like that? Oh, I suppose you think that I should be the one to learn how to cook, huh?
Yeah. It is women's work, isn't it?
Well, I don't do very well in the kitchen.
Well, I don't plan on being queen of the kitchen either.
I think we'll stick to eggs and sandwiches.
Yeah, until you learn how to cook.
So, have you, seen your brother lately?
Uh-uh. I haven't. And I couldn't be happier.
Come on, you don't mean that.
Oh, yes, I do.
Don't you want to get along with him?
Oh, sure, I'd like to get along with him, but it'll never happen.
Well, why don't you give him a chance?
I've given him chances, and the same thing happens time and time again. He tries to run my life. I don't have to take it anymore.
Well, it's too bad. You know, when my mom and I had that fight about my moving in here, well, I'd never admit it to her at the time, but I really missed her. And then when all that stuff happened with Jamie, well, I decided that I should talk to my mom about it. And we made up. And you know, it really feels good to be friends with my mom again.
I'm glad.
Oh, Lee, I wish you'd make up with him. You'd feel so much better if you did.
It's not the same with me and Denny Sally. You and your mom had a good relationship from the start. And Danny and me, well, we're like oil and water. And that'll never change.
Blaine, it's good to see you.
Thank you. Larry said you want to talk to me.
Yes, I do. Please, sit down. Can I have Nellie bring you some coffee?
No, thank you.
Not for me, thanks.
Well, Blaine, I may have some very good news for you.
Well, it's about time, since there's nothing but bad news for the past 3 weeks.
Brian, come on, what's the news?
Well, I had a talk with Mr. Cunningham this morning.
He's the new DA, isn't he?
Yes, and I must say, he's a lot easier to deal with than Zachary Colton ever was.
Now, what'd you two talk about?
Well, he's agreed not to press charges.
Really?
That's great! That's...
But there is one condition.
What?
He wants information.
What kind of information?
Everything you know about the illegal activities that the company is involved in.
Oh, I don't know how much I can tell. I wasn't really involved with anything except the arena and the escort service.
Well, those are the two things he mentioned that he wants information on. He wants to know about the game fixing, and most importantly, about the escort service. And they'll want you to name names, right?
Brian, is this really necessary?
I'm afraid so. You'll have to be totally honest with him, Blake.
Ryan, I don't think I can do that to Melissa and Jason.
Now, look, this will be the end of it then, right?
Yes, I'm sure of it.
I can't believe it. It's been such a nightmare for so long. I never thought it would end.
Oh, it's great. Baby, I'm so happy to see you.
Yes, I'd like the number for the Black Hawk project. Okay, but okay. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye. Yes, can I speak to Denny Hobson, please? Thank you. Hello, Denny? This is Sally Frame.
Sally, this is a surprise.
Listen, I was wondering, are you busy tonight?
Tonight? No, I don't have anything planned.
Well, good. Lee and I would like to have you over for dinner.
Really? I didn't think Lee was interested in seeing me, especially after the last time.
Well, he'd like to start getting along with you better, so he thought he'd like to give it a try.
He actually said that?
Yes, he did.
Well, that, you don't know how happy that makes me feel, Sally. I really appreciate you telling me that.
Well, good. But then you will come to dinner?
Of course, of course. What time?
About 7 o'clock.
I'll be there.
Who is it?
It's me.
Hi, Jamie. How are you doing, sweetie? How are you feeling?
Couldn't be better.
You sure you're getting enough rest?
Yes, I'm getting enough rest.
I'm doing it again, aren't I?
Yep.
I'm sorry, I can't help it. Go on in. I just got to check on Matthew and put these things
Okay, down. Sure, go ahead. Say hi to him.
How would you like something to eat? It looks like you could use it.
Mom?
Well, you do. You look all skin and bones. You should eat more.
No, I'm all right. I didn't come over here to eat.
Okay. Why'd you come over here?
I came over here to tell you that I have to go away for a little while.
You're going away? What are you talking about?
There's a psychiatric clinic just north of town, the Harold Clinic.
Well, why are you going there? What are you going to do there?
You're not listening to me. James Frame is admitting himself into the Harold Clinic for psychiatric observation.
What does that mean?
Just what it says. You know I've been having problems. I mean, I think it's about time.
Was this Mac's idea?
No, it wasn't.
Did he try and talk you out of it?
No.
Then I don't understand why you're doing this.
I need some time alone.
So fine. Take the time alone. But you don't have to admit yourself into a psychiatric hospital in order to get some time off. Is somebody pressuring you about this?
No, nobody's pressuring me. Now, this was my idea. Mom, there's nothing wrong with getting a little help, is there?
You're really determined to do this, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Does Cecile know about this?
Yes.
And what does she say?
She thinks it's a good idea.
I'm sure she does.
Mom, try to understand. Now, this is something I have to do. For a lot of reasons.
Okay, Jamie.
I'm gonna be all right, Mom. Really.
Right, Sally, what's so important? How come you had to see me?
Well, I have a surprise for you.
A surprise?
Yep.
What kind of surprise?
Well, I...
Do you like to order?
Yeah, I'll have a cheeseburger with everything on it, french fries, and a chocolate shake. What kind of surprise?
Ma'am?
I'll have a diet soda. Thanks.
What kind of surprise?
Your brother's coming over for dinner tonight.
What?
You heard me.
He's coming over to our place for dinner? Why?
I invited him.
Sally, how could you do such a thing?
I am so tired of the two of you fighting, and I think if you got together in a relaxed atmosphere, you guys would get along fine.
It won't work. I don't see how you could do this to me, Sally.
Would you try?
Well, it doesn't look like I have much choice now, does it?
Mm-mm.
What are we gonna feed him? I'm not cooking.
He'll think of something.
I'll think of something? You get me into this mess and I've gotta think of something?
You're not mad at me, are you?
Oh.
Lee, I just think that, well, if Denny sees how happy we are together, I mean, how could he be against us? We'll win him over. You'll see, it'll work.
Don't count on it.
You try?
Oh, yeah, I'll try.
Oh, thank you.
Ah, Larry, thanks so much for taking me to see Brian.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Oh, you want some coffee?
No, I want to talk to you, sis.
About what?
About you.
Me? What about me?
Well, do you have any plans now that this is all over?
Plans?
Yeah. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Don't you think it's about time you started thinking about it?
I will, Larry, pretty soon. I just want to take a little time by myself, you know, sort of sort things out.
Yeah, you have to do it here? I mean, I never understood why you had to come back to this place.
I did have to. There are a lot of bad memories for me here, but I feel if I am here, then I'll be able to get over them faster.
That's really stupid, you know?
No, Larry, it is not stupid. See, I can't keep running away from them. I've got to face them, and the sooner I do that, the better off I'll be.
You can't do that moping around here all the time. That's not doing you any good. It's not healthy.
I'm not moping.
Well, what do you call it?
Please, will you just leave me alone? I know exactly what I'm doing. I'll get my life together when I'm ready.
Yeah, when will that be?
I don't know.
Sis, look, I am just worried about you. You're not doing anything with yourself.
Look,
you're trying to live in the past, and that's not going to do you any good.
I appreciate your concern, Larry, but will you please just get off my back? I'm a big girl now, and I can take care of myself.
Oh, can you?
Yes, I can.
Well, you couldn't prove it by me. I'm telling you, Brian, I think that you're living in the past, and you have ignored everybody who loves you and cares for you now.
How can you say that? I see people. I see you. I see Clarice. I see Melissa.
Yeah, have you seen Jerry?
No.
Why not?
Well, maybe he doesn't want to see me. I mean, he hasn't bothered to come over here, has he?
Well, did it ever occur to you that he might be afraid to?
Afraid? Of what?
Afraid that you're mad at him.
Me mad at him? Come on, Larry, you know it's the other way around, isn't it? He's the one... I'm sorry, I can't blame him. I hurt him very badly.
Then why don't you make the first move? You go see him.
I'm not going to do that.
Why not?
Larry, I don't want to talk about Jerry.
You all right?
Jamie was just here. He is checking himself into a psychiatric clinic.
Checking in on his own?
He says it is. I don't think it is. His own idea.
Well, what do you think?
I think Mac has something to do with it.
What's happening?
I think Mac has convinced Russ that Jamie needs to be hospitalized.
That doesn't make any sense. Why would he do something like
that? I don't know. I guess to get Jamie out of the way so Sandy has a clear field.
Mac doesn't operate like that.
Oh, no? He was the one who hired a detective to have him spy on us.
Bad advice. He loves Jamie. He loves him like a son. Wouldn't try to hurt him.
Not so sure about that. He was over here the other day. He tried to convince me that something was terribly wrong with Jamie. Now I think he's convinced Jamie of the same thing.
Rachel, I don't think you believe that. I think if he did make a recommendation like that, then he's done it in Jamie's best interest.
It isn't in Jamie's best interest. It's in Sandy's best interest and in Cecile's best interest.
Hi.
Hi.
What did you fix?
What did I fix?
Yeah, is everything ready?
Everything's ready as it's gonna be.
Okay, well, what did you fix?
I didn't fix anything.
What?
I found a place that fixed pan lasagna.
Uh-huh.
It's in Joey's oven.
Why Joey's oven?
Because ours is broken.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. What else did you get?
I got an antipasto salad. It's in the refrigerator and some frozen broccoli.
Frozen broccoli?
Mm-hmm.
I think we can do without the frozen broccoli.
Well, if you want it, it's in the freezer.
Okay. Did you get any French bread?
Yeah, it's right up here. It's all buttered and garlic and ready for Joey's oven.
Good. I must tell you, I'm very proud of you. You did very well for your very first time entertaining.
Thank you.
Oh, that must be him.
Godzilla.
You promised me that you were going to be nice to him.
I'll be as nice to him as he is to me.
Okay.
I promise.
Hi, Danny.
Hi, Sally.
Come on in, right on time.
Hello, Lee.
Hi, Danny.
Thanks for inviting me over, Sally.
Oh, well, we're glad you could make it.
Why don't you come right down here and make yourself comfortable?
Thanks.
I think I'll go up to Joey's and see if the lasagna's done.
Yeah, I can do that.
No. Stay with your brother.
Well, I must say, I'm very pleasantly surprised.
I know you're dead. I know
don't
you're...
Don't fight me now, Blaine. I've come for you.
No. No.
You're gonna be mine now, Blaine. There's no Jerry Grove to protect you. No Sandy Alexander.
No, you stay away from me.
What's the matter? You don't have to be afraid of me now.
You're dead. I know you're dead. I know. I shot you. You bled to death. I know.
Maybe that's what everyone was supposed to think.
But...
Sometimes you're so naive, Blaine.
No!
jealous, you know. Always hanging around other men. I couldn't bear the thought of you being near another man. That's why I treated you the way I did. But I don't have to do that anymore, do I? I don't have to hurt you anymore, because now you're going to be mine forever. Don't be so frightened. I just want to hold you in my arms again.
No.
I want to touch
no.
you. I want to feel your warmth.
No.
I want to taste your lips. I want to hold your body next to mine.
No! No!
Blaine, you don't want to do that again. All I want to do is love you.
Leave me. Don't come near me.
Put the gun down. It's not going to help you now. You know you can't hurt me anymore.
I'm going to shoot you.
Well, go ahead. Shoot. You can't hurt me. I'm dead.
Oh, no!
What's that supposed to mean? You're pleasantly surprised.
Don't get so defensive, Lee. I was just giving you a compliment.
Yeah, well, it sounds pretty left-handed to me, Denny. Like maybe you don't think we can do anything without somebody older or more mature telling us what to do.
That's not what I meant at all. But if that's the way you want to take it.
Look, maybe we just better talk about something else, huh?
Sure. What do you want to talk about?
Don't patronize me, Denny.
I'm not patronizing you. I'm just agreeing that we shouldn't talk about anything that's going to cause an argument.
Want some wine?
Well, sure.
So, how's that new job of yours?
Strange, but okay.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, it's like I'm not working at all. I'm pulling down a huge salary for doing practically nothing.
Well, what do you do?
Well, that's just it. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. So far all they give me to do is buy one piece of property. That's it. But my boss did put me into a very fancy apartment at the Bayview Towers.
Now, that does sound like a cushy job.
Yes, it is. How about you?
What about me?
Well, are you still working at Corey Publishing?
The Daily Ledger, the newspaper.
Well, same thing, isn't it? Corey Publishing owns the paper, right?
Yeah.
Well, is there any chance of getting promoted there, or is it a dead-end job?
Well, I'm just an errand boy, Denny. And I don't think that they have any plans moving me up to a manager position anytime soon.
You, ever thought of looking for something a little more, future in it? You know, you could be wasting your time where you are.
I like where I'm at, Denny, for now.
You know, Blackhawk's going to be expanding its operation in Bay City pretty soon.
Yeah.
I could, line something up for you.
Thanks a lot. But I like my job at the Daily Ledger.
But if there's no future...
I didn't say there wasn't any future.
Yeah, but you're just an errand boy. Look, Lee, it seems to me that you're smart enough to be doing something better. Something that'll put you where you can go up in the organization.
I like my job, Denny. I'm learning a lot. I got a good boss. And when he feels I'm ready for more responsibility, he'll let me know. So you don't have to worry about it. All right?
Sure.
I'm back. I think that this lasagna should be ready to eat in a few minutes. A little hot. But we could start on the salad. Well, looks like the two of you are getting along just fine.
You know, that's how dreams can be sometimes.
It was almost as if I could feel his touch. His hands were so cold.
Listen, I think you were absolutely crazy to come back to this place. Why didn't you just get rid of it? Get Jordan Scott out of your life for good. Otherwise, he's just going to be back in every dream you have. You trying to torture yourself or something?
Maybe you're right. Melissa.
What?
Coffee.
Oh. I'm sorry. I think I'm about a million miles away here.
I really appreciate you coming over here, you know.
Yeah, sure. There was something you said you wanted to see me about?
Yeah. I saw Brian this morning.
Oh. Well, how's that going?
Very well, actually. They've decided to drop the charges against me.
Well, that's good. That's great.
It is, except for one thing.
What?
In order for them to drop the charges against me, I have to tell the district attorney everything I know about the company's illegal activities.
Well, that's to be expected.
Which means
what?
Melissa, I can't do it. I can't tell them anything without implicating you and Jason.
So? Just don't worry about it, Blaine. I mean, practically everything came out at your trial anyway.
Okay. I just wanted you to know what was happening.
Right. Thanks.
There's something wrong, isn't there?
Hmm?
You keep drifting away.
Yeah. I am drifting.
Melissa, tell me, what's bothering you?
I guess it's Sandy. I'm real worried about him, Blaine.
Okay. Can you talk to Mac?
Yeah.
How'd he take it?
Well, he wasn't too happy about it, but I think he understood.
All right. Did you believe your story about your sister?
I think so.
Good. Now, what about her? Did you get in touch with her?
Yeah. She knows exactly what to do. See, if anybody calls her there, she's going to call here and leave a message.
All right. Good. Now Melissa knows to call here for updates, right?
Well, she said she did.
Okay, great. Now, this one plugged in. All right, let's see how this works.
Try.
Okay. Fantastic. You have reached 555-9680. At the sound of the tone, please leave your message and phone number, and your call will be returned as soon as possible. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Let's hear it.
You have reached 555-9680. At the sound of the tone, please leave your message and phone number, and your call will be returned as soon as possible. Thank you.
Got it. All right. Put it on playback. Okay, we're set. Got it. Forgotten anything? Let's see. I don't think so. Oh, identification.
Oh, ID's right.
Yeah, let me have your wallet.
Okay. Right. Keep the money.
Okay. Let's see. What else?
Have you got my medical records?
Yeah, I've got them in my coat.
All right, you made the changes?
Yeah, I think they look perfect. They're just right.
All right, great. You're a man of many talents, aren't you?
Yeah, well, it comes with a lot of experience, you know?
Okay. Listen, Sandy.
Yeah.
You still sure you want to go through with this?
Yeah, I'm sure.
I mean, it was my idea, you know. If you're having second thoughts.
No, man, I'm not having any second thoughts. Besides, we have to do something, you know. I just hated the idea of staying in that house with Mac and putting him and Amanda in a lot of danger, so.
Man, I kind of felt the same way working at the complex.
Well, you know, it's not exactly the same thing. I mean, you weren't putting Mac in any danger at the complex.
Right, I guess messing up isn't that dangerous, is it?
Yeah, well, look, we better get going.
Okay, right.
I'm kind of worried about you staying up here all alone.
You know what?
I don't know. I'm just concerned about it.
Listen, don't be. I'm going to finally have a chance to do what I've wanted to do for a long time.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Write that great American novel. Really, I've got my typewriter here, loads of paper, and tons of corrective fluid. What more do I need?
I don't know, Jamie. It's just the idea, you know. I just think you need to be with people right now.
People? Sandy, the last thing I need right now is people. I gotta be by myself. Listen, stop worrying. I'm gonna be all right.
Okay.
Well, take care of yourself.
Thanks for everything, man.
Okay.
Oh! What? Look, here, take this.
My wedding ring.
Oh, yeah, your wedding ring.
Okay.
Okay. Take good care of it.
I will. All right. Okay?
Yeah.
Is it time?
It's time.
Okay, buddy, let's go.
You're worried about Sandy. Why? Has something happened to him?
No, he's still safe.
Is Ilse Frederick still after him, though?
Yep.
Then he didn't come up with the money.
No. No, but I don't know. He says it doesn't matter. He seems to feel that Ilse will just take his money and kill him right afterwards.
Well, Ilse, what is he going to do?
Well, he's already done it.
What?
He's left town.
Where'd he go?
Indiana.
Indiana? Mm-hmm. Why Indiana?
Well, he's got a half-sister there, so he feels that he can be safe there, hang out for a while.
Well, if he's there, he'll be safe then, so there's nothing to worry about then, is there?
I don't know about that, Blaine. See, I'm really not certain that he can be safe anyplace anymore.
I'll get it, Louise.
Rachel, what are you doing here?
I want to talk to you.
What about?
I think you know.
I have no idea what you're talking about. And furthermore, Rachel, I really don't appreciate your bursting in here whenever you happen to feel like it.
I don't care whether you appreciate it or not. I'll come over here whenever I think my son is threatened.
Jamie threatened? Will you come in? I don't want to have a discussion like this in the doorway. Please, sit down.
I prefer to stand, thank you.
Suit yourself. Now, what's this about Jamie being threatened?
This scheme to have Jamie locked up?
Scheme, Rachel, there is no scheme to lock Jamie up. This was his own idea. It's something he felt he needed.
I don't believe that, not for a minute.
Well, you'll have to believe it sooner or later, because it's true.
You had nothing to do with his reaching this decision?
I most certainly did not. I didn't even know about the decision until after he had made up his mind, Rachel. Russ talked to me about it, however. He feels it's a very wise decision for Jamie. He feels it's the only way he's going to get the extensive therapy that he needs now.
Well, it will certainly get him out of the way, won't it?
Oh, Rachel, please don't be ridiculous.
Am I? Am I being ridiculous?
Why would I want Jamie out of the way?
I don't know, but I think it has to do with the fact that you have your own son now, and you want my son completely out of the picture.
Rachel, that thought never entered my mind. This decision to commit himself was entirely Jamie's. I had nothing to do with it. But as long as he feels that's what he needs, I'm behind him 100%.
I'm sure you are.
Yes, may I help you?
Yes, I'm James Frame, and
Yes, Mr. Frame, we've been expecting you. Wait here, please. I'll get the doctor.
Dr. Curtis, please call your service. Did I
ever tell you how much I hate hospitals?
Oh, now you tell me.
Yeah.
You gonna change your mind?
No. I'm gonna see this through all the way.
We can walk right out that door.
No way, man.
Okay. Now remember, no visitors.
Right, except for you.
Right.
Or me, as the case may be.
Okay. Sorry. Also, no one can find out who we are. The whole thing's blown. Now, you know.
Yeah, I know that. Okay. We've been through this before.
I know.
You sure you're okay?
Me? The other one is crazy.
You think you're right, as a matter of fact.
Mr. Frame.
Yes, that's me.
Now, what does that last remark mean?
I expect that you and Sandy are looking forward to Jamie locking himself up so Sandy can so generously offer to take over for him.
Well, Rachel, you're wrong.
Am I?
Sandy's not even in town.
He isn't.
He's left town.
When?
This morning.
Where did he go?
You may or may not know it, Rachel, but Sandy is in a great deal of personal danger. He felt he'd be safer if he went somewhere out in Indiana to visit a half-sister of his.
So who's taking over for Jamie while he's gone? Cecile?
Well, she's the editor, isn't she? What's wrong with that?
She certainly winds up the big winner in this, doesn't she?
And what does that mean?
Only that you're incredibly blind.
Rachel.
We have everything prepared for you, Mr. Frame. And if you want to take a few minutes to say goodbye to your friend, why then, Miss Franzen will show you to your room.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Feldman.
Yes, and I'll stop by tomorrow and see you.
Right.
Well, it was very nice meeting you, Mr. Alexander.
Same here, Doctor. Yes.
Well, I guess this is it.
You take care of yourself.
You too, man.
I'll keep in touch.
You better.
Oh, okay. All right.
And I really hope this works.
So do I. Bye, Sandy.
It's Jamie. It's Jamie.
Now, Mr. Alexander is to be your only visitor. Is that right, Mr. Frame?
Yes, yes, that's right. That's right.
Is he a friend or a relative?
Well, actually, he's a little of both. He's my half-brother.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another World.